Hello viewers, welcome to AP's Ophthalmology Pulse. Today we shall discuss the clinical grading of a relative afferent pupillary defect. In our previous video, we defined an RAPD as a defect in the pupillary reaction of one eye compared to that of the other eye due to a defect in the afferent pupillary pathway. This is also referred to as a Marcus Gunn pupil. The clinical grading was described by Bell and is relevant only when the light is shone on each eye for exactly 3 seconds before swinging to the other eye. Bell described 5 grades of RAPD. Since the RAPD is seen when light is swung from the normal to the affected eye, in the examples for each clinical grade, the right eye will be taken to be the abnormal eye and the effect of the swing from the left eye to the right eye alone will be demonstrated. In grade 1 RAPD, there is a weak initial constriction and greater redilatation. In grade 2 RAPD, there is an initial stall and greater redilatation. In grade 3 RAPD, there is an immediate dilatation. The grade is determined after taking the average of a minimum of 6 swings. Now, if you get a grade 3 RAPD, then further evaluation is required to determine whether it is really a grade 3, grade 4 or a grade 5. Shine the light in front of the left eye for 6 seconds. This results in relative bleaching of this eye, thereby making it weaker, and this eye now behaves as if a neutral density filter has been placed over it. When the light is now swung to the right eye, note what happens, and the grading system is as follows. If the initial response is a constriction or a stall, then the APD remains grade 3. If the initial response is immediate dilatation followed by a secondary constriction, the RAPD is a grade 4. If the initial response is immediate dilatation with no secondary constriction or no direct response to direct light, the RAPD is a grade 5. Grade 5 is also referred to as an amaurotic pupil. That is, the eye has no perception of light and the pupil does not show even mild constriction to direct light but responds normally to consensual light. So that's it for today. We shall discuss grading with neutral density filters in the next video. If you like what you saw, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's Ophthalmology Pulse. You may watch my other videos by clicking on the thumbnails. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to weekly updates. Thank you for watching.